Hello, thank you for joining the Texas Instruments new product update webinar. We are thrilled to announce that starting next Thursday, May 11th, Texas Instruments will be transitioning hosting the MPU webinar series from WebEx to ON24. Please be sure to visit ti.com/MPU to register for the event or reach out to your TI salesperson or field application engineer for the registration link. A few quick announcements before we get started. This webinar will be recorded and available online at ti.com/MPU. All phone lines will be muted, so if you have questions, please use the chat box and we will try to answer in real time, or you can contact your TI salesperson or field application engineer. Today's topic is next generation low voltage dual bridge motor driver with current regulation. I will now pass it over to Jennifer Jordan for introductions.
Thanks, Kelly. Thank you everyone for joining this new product update this morning. As stated earlier, the topic for today is gonna be Texas Instruments next generation low voltage dual bridge motor driver with current regulation. So this is gonna be a new family of our stepper driver portfolio that's intended for low power applications. So, to start off with, I'm going to give an overview of what our DRV841X family is. It's comprised of three main devices. Within that overview, I'm going to go over the different features that they have, such as the integrated current regulation and how that helps to reduce your board layout size. One of our devices has a new feature called IPROPI, which is current proportional current monitoring solution. And I'll talk a little bit about how that also helps to reduce your solution size and improve your system efficiency. And finally, part of our feature overset is using the current sense output to detect stall detection and load changes. So all of these features are available within our new low voltage stepper family. I'll wrap it up by going over the resources for getting started and how to get your hands on one of our EVMs or any of our collateral. If at any point during this presentation you have a question, please feel free to use the chat. I do have another one of the engineers online who could help answer any questions that you have, or feel free to reach out directly to your TI sales representative. So, the products that I'm going to talk about today are the DRV8410, DRV8411, and DRV11A. So this is our low voltage dual bridge motor driver with current regulation that supports, 11 volts operation. And so starting off with the first pillar for this family is that for this next generation low voltage stepper driver, we're really focused on the advanced sensing and control. So these devices have an integrated analog current regulation that helps to manage your motor torque and current. So typically for any type of current monitoring or current regulation, you would have external shunt resistors that you are monitoring the current over, but these devices integrate that solution into the device so you no longer have to use those bulky resistors on the outside. We can do that internally. These devices also have better diagnostics due to that and higher performance control. They're also really great for low voltage and battery powered applications. So one of the other pillars that I'll mention a little bit later is focused on the low leakage current, so that if you have any type of battery powered applications or you just need to conserve power for energy standards, these devices have improved greatly on that standard. Some of the benefits that we have for the advanced sensing and control is that you're able to protect your motor by regulating current during inrush and stall conditions. You're able to detect motor load, stall conditions, and end of travel with the analog current feedback. So anytime you're using a stepper driver, particularly if you're using it for smart locks or any type of application where you need to determine that it's hit the end of the line, that either your application is fully locked or fully at the end position, these are great devices to help detect that. We also help to improve safety of the mechanical components and users by detecting high load conditions. So by integrating that analog current regulation and current sensing, we're able to help provide a higher level of information and feedback for your system. And we also help to reduce the heat dissipation by limiting that large inrush current. So in a lot of these low voltage applications, you're in a very space constrained, probably an enclosed environment. So it's very important that the main component, your motor, is not overheating due to these inrush or stall conditions. So kind of moving to the second pillar that I wanted to talk about for the playing off of the integrated analog current regulation is that there's a feature that we've integrated into the DRV 8411A. So this is called what we call IPROPI solution, and it stands for current proportional current solution. And what that is that it's a current mirror that we have inside the device that creates a scaled down version of the output current and sends that on our IPROPI pin that you can send back to your microcontroller in order to monitor that current. And what you can see here is that by integrating this solution and having a single pin output that you can send this information back, is that you don't have to have those external shunt resistors that I was talking about earlier. So you see at the bottom of the page the solution size between the DRV 8410 and 11 and the DRV 8411A. So this is a really great option for even smaller solution size. So if you need this for toys, IP network camera solutions, or anything where you're trying to get smaller and lighter, the IPROPI solution has now become available in these low voltage stepper drivers. So some of the benefits for this is, again, the small solution size. You have better power dissipation with this as well. You can do competitive current regulation accuracy. So the IPROPI solution has some of the best current regulation accuracy, plus or minus 2%, which is really great. And then moving forward, the third pillar is that, so kind of also mentioning, not only do you get a small solution size with the IPROPI and the integrated current monitoring, but we also are putting it into a small HT SOP and QFM package that has an integrated capless charge pump. So these devices are able to get down to 1.65 volt operation for those really low voltage applications. And it is also pin to pin with other devices within our portfolio. So we have a previous generation DRV 8833 and DRV 8833C, and also the DRV 8847 that are actually in the same package solution size. So if you're using this previous generation device, you can transition to these new ones that have better features, lower quiescent current, and it's pin to pin drop in replacement. So some of the benefits of these, smaller solution size, again, is that integrated charge pump, so you don't have to have it external, and we're still able to get down to that low voltage operation. And it also does the integrated current sensing and regulation, all within these 5x4.4 and 3x3 packages. Finally, the last pillar is low power and long battery life. I've touched upon this a couple times, especially with those lower power sleep mode and quiescent currents. But with these devices, one of the focuses, while keeping it pin to pin with our current portfolio, was to increase So while keeping it pin to pin with the rest of our portfolio, we also really wanted to increase the specs and the performance for your application. So that wide, low voltage range, again, with that integrated charge pump, 1.65 volts all the way to 11 volts, and then also that low power sleep mode. So we're able to get less than 40 nanoamps of standby power, which lengthens battery life and also conserves on power. So again, the DRV-841X family focuses on advanced sensing and control, a small solution size, long power, long battery life, and integrating a new feature called IPROPI with the DRV-8411A. And how that kind of looks stacked up to the rest of our portfolio here, So you can see that the devices that I just talked about are here with the 2.5 amp peak and 4 amp peak currents. Our previous generation devices, 8833C, had a 2 amp peak current, and 8833 had a 3.3 amp peak current. So the 8411 also is able to reach a higher current than either of the previous generation devices. And so you can see here that throughout our portfolio, all of these devices are pin to pin. The 8411A can be pin to pin with certain modifications. Again, 11A is the one that has that IPROPI current regulation, but this allows for you to have scalability across your devices. But the 8410, 11, and 11A are the only devices within this family that can get down to 1.65 volts. So here's just a more in-depth look of a spec-by-spec comparison across the portfolio. So the pin-to-pin devices that I mentioned earlier, the older generation, is able to meet the same specs. But one thing that I did want to point out was that as you move forward in our generation, we want to increase the voltage range. So the 8833 and 33C only span 2.7 volts to 10.8 volts. Our new generation slightly expands that to 1.65 to 11 volts while still maintaining similar on resistance, but increasing again that max overcurrent protection on the 8411 should you need that in your application. Besides that, everything is pin to pin. But one thing that I did want to note that if you are currently using our DRV 8833 or 33C is that our new generation 8410 and 11, typically on your VNT and VCP pins, you need an external capacitor to set that feature. The DRV 8411 does not require these two capacitors. So it still is pin-to-pin drop-in replacement. Those pins on the new devices are simply no connect, which helps to reduce your BOM and cost. It might not be a lot, but that's definitely something moving forward that we're just trying to eliminate all of those little unnecessary capacitors and resistors that you would need on the outside. So here's a one pager for the DRV 8410 and 11. This just kind of gives you an overview of everything that I've just talked about. And one thing that I did want to point out here is, again, the applications that we're really targeting for these are the electronic point of sales, video surveillance, toys, smart locks, anything that is low voltage that you would need stepper driver control for. And then the DRV 8411A, again, with that IPROPI current regulation, it's targeting all of those same applications, but in addition, that integrated current mirror also is really applicable for medical devices, motorized blinds, or anything where you need a finer level of information. The DRV 8411A is a great choice for that. And it, again, it comes in an HTSSOP package or a QFN. Okay, so that is the broad overview for our DRV 84-1X family. It's a fairly simple set of devices for our low voltage applications, but definitely we wanted to focus on increasing the performance, increasing your battery life, and making it easier for you to put into your application. So if you want to get started using these devices or evaluating them, we have several different resources. Here we have the links to each of the product folder pages and the evaluation modules. There's also a couple of technical papers that I recommend that you get started with. We have Advantages of Integrated Current Sensing that details exactly the benefits that you would get for your system, the thermal improvements and all of that. And then we also have an FAQ if you're getting started with the DRV 8411A. We have an FAQ of how to configure that IPROPI and current sensing for your application. If you have any more questions or if you want to revisit this lecture, please visit ti.com/MPU for more information on the new products. And I believe I will hand it back over to Kelly.
Great, thank you, Jennifer. And yes, thank you for attending today's MPU webinar. And just a reminder to please visit ti.com/MPU to register for next week's MPU presentation. Our next topic is TI's new ESD protection devices for CAN and LIN. Thank you everyone and have a great day.